My name is Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to review dynamic exits in Studio. A dynamic exit refers to the URL loaded when a dynamic ad is clicked on. It's usually related to the product being shown, and that URL comes from your data feed. This video describes the workflow for setting up dynamic exits in Studio. Now, the simplest case is an ad which doesn't use a gallery or a carousel component. Here's an example from another one of my videos titled Dynamic in Studio-Google Web Designer. You'll see my creative contains only placeholder content. But when I preview it in Studio, you'll see it's loading data from my feed. Refresh it. Now we're seeing product number 0. Look at my feed for product 0. We're seeing this name, this image, and here is a URL for my exit for this product. Now when I set up this ad, I use the simple static exit. So when I click anywhere on the ad, it'll load a static URL, like a landing page. What we want to have happen is this to exit to the URL associated for that product. Let me show you how to do that in Google Web Designer. First thing we'll do is select the current event and delete it. Then we're going to look over in our components panel and open up interaction and grab a tap area. Then with the transform control selected, I'm going to stretch this out to cover the ad. And in my dynamic panel, I'm going to click the plus icon to make a new binding. We'll select that tap area. We're going to look for exit override URL. And we're going to drill into our feed, the first item, exit URL, and get the URL. Say OK, and we'll publish this. Now when that's done, we switch over to Studio. We reload our creative. When I click on the ad, now we'll see we're getting product 1. Just to make sure this is really working, let's reload it and get another image. Here's number 5. Let's click on that. Here's product 5. So that's good. Now, next thing we might want to do is combine static and dynamic exits in a single ad. So you might want to have a logo up here, which goes to a home page, and maybe some disclaimer text down here, which goes to a legal page. So let's see how we can do that. Back in Web Designer, I'm going to double click this new tap area, give it a new name, exit default. Then I'll copy and paste it, and I'm going to call that one exit product. And note this layer is on top. So I'm going to make this just cover the product area. And I'm going to select exit default and change the exits on that. Now one trick over here in the dynamic panel, I can choose selection, and now I'll just see the binding on that selection. I'm going to select it and delete it. With it still selected, I'm going to move to the events panel, click the plus icon, and add a new event, Google Ad, Exit Ad, GWD Ad. Going to put an arbitrary ID in here, and I'm going to put a full URL to my landing page. Okay, and we're going to publish again. Now when that's done, we'll switch back to Studio and reload the page. Now when I click in the corners, I'm getting my static URL, and when I click on the product, I'm getting the correct product. That concludes this demo, Dynamic Exits in Studio. Thanks for watching.